Love is God, and God is love. A relationship without God is as good as using it, because God is the foundation of love. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. How are you doing? My name is John Nathan Owora. We are talking parenting. Proverbs 22 verse 6 tells us that train up a child in the way they should go, and when they are older, they will not depart from it. We train the heart, we train the head, we train the hands. We're talking parenting children. For you who's watching this, if you've missed the other episodes, please look for them and watch. We're going to number them. There may be many, but let's try to go over them. Rule number one, as a child in a home, as we're training you, or as we're talking to you, or as a parent, as we're talking to children, rule number one, it's the role of a child to go to school and to pass. If you have a child who's going to school, it's their role to go to school. You may pay tuition, yes, but it's their role to take up the responsibility to go to school. It's their responsibility to go to school and to pass. You can't force knowledge into their heads. Number two, it's the role or the responsibility of a child to protect and take good care of the home and personal properties. Any property in the home, whether personal or family property, is the role of a child to take good care of it. It's a bicycle, if it's a motorcycle, if it's a plate, if it's a cup, it's your role to take good care of it. It's also your role to behave well as a child. It's the role of a child to behave well. You can behave the way you want. No child should behave the way they want. One of the ways of honoring our parents is by behaving well. It's also the role of a child to take care of the house and make sure that it's clean, like washing dishes, like slashing the compound, like mopping the house. That's the role of a child. The parents help, yes, but if your child and you're of age, if your child is of age, it's their role to help in the cleanliness of our home. Do not allow children to do their own things. Don't allow children to sit back as you are working. The Bible is saying train up a child. And we say this in the previous episodes, that training a child involves showing them what to do. Hands-on. It's the role of a child to pray. We're talking prayer. Prayer is talking to God. It's the role of a child to know that there is God in heaven and God loves him or her so much, and it's their responsibility to talk to God and ask God for forgiveness, ask God for anything they need, but also give thanks to God. It's their role. It's the role of a child to take care of their little ones. When a child is older, it's their role to ensure that their brothers and sisters are growing up well. So it's the role of a child, of an older child, to be an example. It's their responsibility. You don't behave the way you want. That's not for you. If you have younger siblings, you're supposed to be an example to them. I have three sisters. It's my role as their elder brother to take responsibility, to be an example for them to follow. I can't say this and I'm doing the opposite. I must be an example. It's the role of a child, to abstain from sex until marriage, whether they're with you or they're not with you as a parent. And if your child and you're watching this, you have one body. Your body has no spare parts. It's your role. It's your responsibility to take care of your body. The Bible says all other sin is outside the body. Sexual sin is in the body. Sexual sin targets your body directly. So you need to be responsible for your body. You have one life to live, no spare parts. So it's your responsibility, or it's the responsibility of a child to abstain from sex until marriage. Avoid fornication. It's important. Fornication is sex before marriage. It's the role of a child to take care of personal hygiene. Bathing is a responsibility of a child. The parent can help them, yes, teach them, train them, but it's the role of a child to have to do personal hygiene, laying their bed when they wake up, bathing, smearing, ensuring that their nails are cut. It's the responsibility of a child. Dear parents, it's important that we teach our children their responsibilities, because if we don't, we're in trouble. It's also the role or the responsibility of a child to obey instructions. Children need to obey the instructions of their parents, especially if their parents are giving right instruction. But if they're giving wrong instructions, it's important that the child obeys as they think through what kind of instruction it is. I don't think there's any parent out there who has given birth to their children who would really want to destroy the life of their child, unless there is something wrong in their head or unless they are drunk. So it's important for children to obey the instructions given to them by their parents. If your father says, don't go out at night, your father says, go fetch water, your mother says, help me here, it's the responsibility of a child to obey those instructions. It's also the responsibility of a child to respect others in the home. You are not alone in that home. As you obey instructions, respect the elders, respect your mom, respect your dad, respect your brothers and your sisters. Even when you are on top of the world, it's your responsibility as a child, it's a responsibility of a child in a home to respect others in a home. That's very, very important. It's the responsibility of a child to go to church. Parents take you to church. I love that. But after they've taken you to church and shown you the way, you need to continue going to church. A child needs to continue going to church, whatever class you're in. Wake up in the morning, bathe, prepare yourself, organize yourself, and go to church. We need to organize ourselves. We need to organize ourselves in time and go to church. This is very, very, very important. It's my responsibility to go to church. It's my responsibility to pray, yes, but my responsibility to go to church. And when I mean church, I mean a gathering of Christians. You need to go for fellowship as well. It's your responsibility. This is very, very important for us. And lastly, it's the responsibility of every child. Responsibility of every child to know that their parents are very, very important. Parents will not always be there. Not all the time. And if you're watching this and don't have a parent, I do not know how to address you. But one thing I know, that you have a parent somewhere. It's your responsibility to know that parents are very important. They may not have everything, they may not give you everything, but they're important. We're talking roles of a child in a home. Dear parents, let's teach our children this. It's part of parenting children. Thank you so much for watching. Till next time, God bless you.